Yes, Frank, I know you're the editor of the school newspaper, but I can't write this article because I think it's stupid. Feminism, myth or mythiv? Okay, we will talk about it tomorrow. All right, bye.
It was a simple misunderstanding.
What?
Yeah, they told me not to talk about it, but, you know, I have one thing to say right here and now. That goat was already dead.
I don't want to hear about this.
Smart girl, it'll blow over in a year or two.
If anybody up there is listening, please save me from this insanity.
Hi there, curly lips.
No one was listening.
Exeter! Mark! Is that you? Who wants to know?
Mrs. Exeter's future husband?
I don't believe this.
Mark! I'm glad you dropped by.
Exeter, why don't you sit down and take a load off your duck waders? I mean, all that rubber must get irritating sometimes. What's this I hear about a Mrs. Exeter?
Oh, Mork, I'm so excited. I just... Pepe, you sit under me one more time and you've sucked your last margarita. Now then, where was I? Oh, yes. Her name is Ambrosia Malspar. Of the Hog's Breath Gulch, Malspar.
Heard of them. I thought they were all caught.
From the moment we met, I heard bells.
Oh, she's a prize fighter, eh?
Romantic, you're not. I dropped by so I could invite you two to dinner tonight, so you can meet Ambrosia. Are you free?
I don't think that we could possibly...
Oh, of course we are.
Mork, I don't care to meet an invisible fiancé.
Mindy, how long could it take? Where should we meet?
Here, say about 8.
You're picking us up?
No, no, no. We'll eat here.
Oh, that's real convenient, Min. We don't have to make reservations.
Wait a minute. You expect me... I'm supposed to...
Oh, please, don't worry about feeding Pepe. Tonight's his highlight tournament.
Min, I'm real proud of you. I mean, I know sometimes you think that Exeter is a twit. But yet you overcame your hang-ups and you invited Heena's fiancé over here for dinner. You're a credit to Shixedom.
Mork?
Min?
Stop it.
I'm sensing a lot of hostility, Min.
What's bothering and tickling your little innards? What's up?
Okay. You, Exeter, and Ambrosia.
Oh, that's good. I'm glad you got that off your chest. Now, did you make that clam dip like that?
I'm not finished yet.
Estamas?
Mas, mas, more. I resent Exeter inviting himself to dinner almost as much as I resent having to cook dinner for an invisible fiancé. I mean, we're into the foothills of kinky here.
Have you ever considered that Exeter's fiancé might be a real flesh-and-blood woman?
No.
Me neither. But come on, Min. I mean, Exeter means well. If this will make him happy, at least let him have his moment. I mean, people in robes have so few. The lovebirds are here right now. We'll be right with you, little bosoms. Min, I want you to be nice to Exeter and try not to stare at Ambrosia. Mindy, it's Exeter! And guess who's with him?
You must be Ambrosia. You're everything I imagined. I like your dress.
Who are you talking to?
I'm talking to the lovely Ambrosia.
But there's nobody there! I think the little lady's been smoking her braids again. I mean, you don't see anybody here, do you?
Not me.
Now, he thinks I'm the one that's crazy?
Oh, I didn't say that. I just said your oil wasn't touching the dipstick.
Did you or did you not state that you were bringing your fiancé here to dinner tonight?
Methinks I hear her dainty step upon the stair. And this is my beloved.
All right, that's it. The party is over.
Gee, I'm sorry I missed you.
Mark, Mindy, I would like you to meet Ambrosia Malspa.
He's over here, man.
I see her.
May I sit down?
Oh, yeah, sure. Come on in. I'm sorry.
It's about time. Be gentle with her. She could use a little hamburger helper.
Don't worry. Your kind of problem doesn't carry the stigma it used to.
Stigma?
So, Mork, you're Exidor's best friend. Tell me about yourself.
Well, I guess you can kind of call me a son of a black hole. My mom was a petri dish. My dad was an eyedropper. Kind of a cosmic clone.
Just to double check, Mindy's the one with the problem?
So, how did you two lovebirds meet?
She chalked me.
Excuse me? Oh, this must be something of the new sexual revolution.
Oh, no, I don't think so. You see, I'm a meter maid. And I was just minding my own business, just riding on my motor scooter, chalking tires. And Exy was lying on his back in the street, fixing his burr.
I bet the hard part was jacking him up, right?
And I accidentally chalked his boots.
Oh. Why don't we all have some cheese hors d'oeuvres before dinner?
Tell you what, I'll take the d'oeuvres.
You two take your time. Amber and I will just sit here and make little fishy faces at one another.
I just can't get over it. She's real and she seems perfectly normal.
Unless she's a hologram.
She's nice, she's charming, and she's sane. I mean, she's nothing like Exidor. I'll bet you she's gonna be good for him. I mean, look at even tonight, he's acting relatively normal.
Stop that pounding! We're not deaf!
Hold that thought.
I'll get it! Stop that pounding! I'm coming! What are you doing here?
Who is it, sweetheart?
It's Peppy!
It's Peppy?
Looks like Peppy to me.
No, it can't be Peppy. Peppy's playing highlight tonight. What am I saying? It's a door. It can't be Peppy.
Mork, Mindy, I know you're trying to protect Exidor, but it's as plain as the nose on your face what's going on, especially when Peppy's standing right there.
Yes?
Exidor, you promised me Peppy wouldn't be here tonight.
But Guppy Lips!
Why should we ever be alone? Why does he always have to tag along? You said you wanted to light my fire, but three on a match is too much.
But flamingo clothes! Peppy, you stay right here. Don't you dare follow us!
I don't want to talk about it. I'm going to bed. For a week.
In Muscatel heaven.
Thanks for the ride, boys.
Come on, Exidor. Here we go. Why don't you sit down?
What's wrong? She said she wouldn't marry me if I was the last prophet on Earth, which I am.
I'm sorry to hear about that.
One day you'll meet a girl that's right for you in every way.
Do you really think so?
No, but at least you had hope for a moment.
Thanks, Mark. I just dropped by to say adios. I'm shuffling off this mortal coil, and I want you to have all my worldly possessions here.
Oh, thank you. That's what... It's empty.
Of course. That suitcase is all my worldly possessions. Except for a large rock. And I'm saving that for transportation.
You're saving a rock for transportation?
Yes. I'm going to tie it to my leg when I go on vacation. In Atlantis.
Whoa, come on, Nax. You're not going anywhere. You're going to spend the night here, and I guarantee tomorrow morning things will look a lot better.
But what if they don't?
Well, you just have to stay here until they do, and that may take forever, but that's all right.
Mork.
Min? It's settled. Here we go, Axel. Time to hit the sack, little Mondo Dodo. Here we go.
Oh, this is very kind of you both. You won't even know I'm here.
Good night.
Night.
Oh! Oh!
Mork, he's baying.
Of course, Min, it's a full moon. So then what happens? The alpha says to the beta, the muzzle, take it off, I want to kiss her. The alpha said, why are we nailed to a chicken?
That's wildly hysterical, Mark. But I'm empty. My life is over. I'm going out and kiss my burrow goodbye.
Where's the old Exodore spirit?
Locked up in Ambrosia's cold, cold heart.
Will you kindly take your boots off my sofa?
Whoa, whoa, Min. Whoa, he's got squatter's rights. He shows him compassion. This man's on the ragged edge.
If you two don't mind, I think I'll take a little hike upstairs to Mork's lake. The leaves are changing, you know. They just drop off, shrivel up, and die. It's hard to keep from laughing.
That is it, Mork. He's got to go, or I'm going to end up as Looney Tunes as he is.
Oh, come on, Min, you got to help him. You can't just discard him like an old Carter cabinet member.
I can't. But I can try to get Ambrosia to take him back. Oh, come on, Ambrosia. Why don't you tell me why you really broke up with Exodore?
I'd rather not discuss it, Mindy.
Well, you shouldn't just let him go. Exodore is a very unique person. I mean, when they dropped Exodore, they broke the mold.
They sure did. He's kind, considerate, a snappy dresser. And let's not forget that swell sense of humor.
Well, then why did you break up with him?
Well, it's that friend of his, Peppy. He won't leave us alone. We go to the swap meet, there's Peppy. We go skateboarding, there's Peppy. Tailgating. Sometimes I wish he'd just disappear.
What exactly does Peppy look like?
I don't know. You'd have to ask Exodore.
Then you know that Peppy doesn't exist?
Well, I wouldn't say that. I mean, a lot of people believe in men from outer space. I've never seen one, but that doesn't mean they don't exist.
Good point.
Exodore sees Peppy, and he's never lied to me yet. Besides, you have to believe in the man you love.
You know, you're a very special person, Ambrosia.
No, I'm not. Because I haven't been totally honest with you or Exidor. Pepe isn't the real problem.
He's not?
No, I'm old-fashioned. Before a couple gets married, I believe the man should ask the woman to marry him.
Well, what if Exidor did propose to you? Would you marry him then?
No.
Why not?
Mindy, he's never told me he loves me.
What are you doing?
Isn't it obvious? I'm drowning in your lake. Now get out of here and let me sink in peace.
But I've got great news for you. Ambrosia wants you back.
Ambrosia wants me back? Save me! Save me! Wait! Wait! The castle drowned!
What do I do?
Quick, grab my dinghy!
All right. Just tread rug. I'll be right there.
Here, a life preserver. Hold on to that.
From a watery grave. Tell me, when can I see my fox?
Well, she's coming tonight, and all you have to do is one thing, and she'll take you back.
Anything. Name it.
All you have to do is say, I love you. Will you marry me?
That's it. Back to catfish country.
No, wait, wait. I thought you loved Ambrosia.
I do.
Then why can't you tell her?
Mork, this may come as a bit of a surprise, but I'm just a little eccentric.
No.
You see, Mork, I just can't get myself to say that phrase. In the orphanage where I was raised, nobody ever said it to me.
Well, you've got to. It's for your own happiness.
But you don't understand. It's a psychological problem. Everyone's allowed one little hanger.
There she is.
I can't say it.
Well, if you don't, you're going to lose her. Now, remember, I love you.
That's really nice. But what are we going to do about Ambrosia?
Hi, Ambrosia. Hi, Mindy.
Let me go! I can't! No, don't grab me there!
Is Exidor here?
I don't know. I'll check. Mork! We have company!
And be right down. Get down there!
I think that they're probably freshening up a bit.
Exy won't go anywhere unless he's just so.
No! Oh, hi there, dimple hips.
Hi, Exy.
Does Exidor have something he wants to say to Ambrosia?
Huh? Do you have something you want to say to Ambrosia?
Can't think of anything.
Think again.
You can do it.
I have something I want to say. It's impossible. I can't. My life is over.
Well, I got a good idea. Let's play charades.
Charades?
Well, you see, Exidor has trouble communicating with H-E-R.
I'd love to play charades.
Exidor, you be the giver, you be the receiver. Exidor, go. Hit it. First word. I.
I got it. I love you, and will you marry me?
I thought you'd never get it.
The answer is I love you, too, and you bet.
Oh, I can't believe it.
She loves me!
Exie, will you walk me home alone?
Just a moment. Pepe! Them wedding bells have broken up that whole gang of ours!
Hasta luego, amigo! Thank you, sweetheart. You're too good to me.
I'd do anything for you because I love you and I want to marry you. Oh.
Twice in one night.
And there's a lot more where that came from.
Well, it took the both of us, but we pulled it off. Hey, how about going down to the deli with me? I'll buy you a soda.
I still feel kind of strange about one thing.
What?
Well, I feel kind of sorry for Pepe. I mean, where's he gonna get work with an invisible green car? Orson. Come in, Orson. Mork calling Orson. Come in, Orson. Mork calling Orson. Come in, great super scooper in the sky.
Your report, Mork.
Oh, sir, I am so excited. My best friend is getting married next week.
How long do marriages on Earth last?
Oh, until death do they part, or a quick trip to Reno, whichever comes first. But I think Exidor's marriage is going to last forever.
Exidor? Isn't he the one you told me was strange even by Earth standards?
Ah, sir, with love, there are no standards. You see, no matter how strange or bizarre you are, there's always a certain someone who'll love you for it. Love gives everyone a chance to be happy.
Chance? You make it sound like a lottery.
Well, sir, in a way, love is a lottery. And the only losers are the ones who won't gamble. Exidor's marriage promises to be one of the most unusual in the history of mankind. Don't be late. Don't come empty-handed. Nanu, Nanu.